Welcome to Shah's IAS Institute. This is a video on current affairs, important keywords in current affairs, topic-wise. So current affairs has various sections. One of the sections is polity and bills and acts under it. So under this, an important keyword which will be covered in this video is Citizenship Amendment Act 2019. So you should know all about it. So what is it all about? CAA, against which widespread protests have been held across the country. So what are the salient features of this act, which earlier was a bill? So what has been put forth is the provision of this act now. So it has the cutoff date for Indian citizenship, eligibility for Indian citizenship. So cutoff date you should know for this bill, it is December 31, 2014. So means those who have stayed in the country till before, have been staying in the country before 31st December 2014, will be eligible to get citizenship. And who are these? These are for specific communities, religious communities from three neighboring countries of India: Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. So these are minorities from these three countries, means Hindus, Buddhists, Christians, Parsi, Jains and Sikhs. So they would be eligible to get citizenship of India if they have been here before 31st December 2014. However, there have been widespread protests against Citizenship Amendment Bill 2. So while the bill was being formulated, a change has been made. It will not apply to northeastern states, because northeastern states are the ones which bear the brunt of illegal migrants. So it would not apply to those regions. So it will not apply to tribal areas of Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura and Mizoram. So these are the four states. Again, an important fact which you should know, these are four states mentioned in the sixth schedule of the Indian Constitution. So sixth schedule of the Indian Constitution talks of tribal areas of four states which have specific provisions for them. So these are the four states under it. So you should know northeastern states means the seven sisters. Sikkim is not amongst them. So the seven states are, four are covered here. Remaining are Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland and Manipur. So Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland and Mizoram, as a matter of fact, are also protected by inner line permit. So inner line permit is also a system which we should understand. So inner line permit is applied in tribal areas of northeastern states. So here you can see these are the four states in which inner line permit system is prevailing. Means to visit the tribal areas here, you need a special permit. So anybody from outside cannot visit this region. So this is now applicable even to another northeastern state, which is Manipur. So effectively all seven northeastern states are covered through protections. Only regions in northeast where Citizenship Amendment Act would be available will be in some parts of Assam and Tripura, right? Because those are non-tribal areas, you can understand. Then you can see further that all cases against non-Muslim illegal migrants before any authority, including foreigners tribunals or courts, shall stand abated. Because now they have been considered for providing citizenship. So if you are eligible to get citizenship, you should not be, according to present laws, you cannot be an illegal migrant. If you are an illegal migrant, you are not eligible to get Indian citizenship. When we are applying this for minority communities from three northeastern states, so they are not, will not be considered as illegal migrants. There are cases against them before any authority, including foreigners tribunals, will be abated. Also, you should understand that this cutoff date for citizenship, why is cutoff date for citizenship required? It is one of the ways to acquire citizenship, that is citizenship by naturalization. Means you can be a citizen by birth, you can be a citizen by descent. Descent means your parents have been citizens of India, so by descent you are a citizen of India. So if a person is not a citizen by birth, not citizen by descent, still a person can become a citizen of India by naturalization. So this citizenship by naturalization has a requirement that person should be staying within the country for 12 years before being eligible to apply for citizenship. And the staying should be legally, not as illegal migrant, but through a legal process. They have the visa, they have the permission to stay in the country. So that is how citizenship by naturalization happens. But in this case, illegal migrants are, non-Muslim illegal migrants are considered to be eligible. And here you can see the naturalization process, it requires 12 years, but for these particular set of illegal migrants, the citizenship by naturalization can happen even if they stay in the country for half the period, that is only for 6 years. So that's what the are the key provisions of Citizenship Amendment Act. So you should know there are five ways of citizenship. One is citizenship by birth. You can see this is under the Citizenship Act. Then second is citizenship by descent. and third is citizenship by registration, and what we are talking of presently is citizenship by naturalization. But then in citizenship by registration and naturalization, it has been clearly mentioned that the person should not be an illegal migrant, but that relaxation has been provided presently in the Citizenship Amendment Act 2019 for non-Muslim migrants from Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. Then further details on citizenship by naturalization are provided here. So when we said it is in general 12 years before applying for citizenship, how are these 12 years divided? Like it should be 1 year before, immediately before applying for citizenship, the person should be staying in the country, and the remaining 11 years also should be 11 years out of the last 14 years before that. So that's when you become eligible to apply for citizenship of India by naturalization, and provided you are not illegal migrant. That was the case in general, changed by this present act. Also, with respect to Citizenship Amendment Act, you should know about other rules which also have been changed in the country in recent past, that is in last year as such, that is in 2018. You can see these are the rules. This is not a law. Laws are made by the parliament. Citizenship Amendment Act is a law made by the parliament. These are rules. Rules under the act are formulated by the executive, not the legislature, not the parliament. So in this case, it is the executive, the government, the home ministry. So home ministry had notified rules in 2018 on citizenship. So these rules made it mandatory that anyone applying for citizenship by registration in the country should declare their religion. So religion has to be declared. So this was made mandatory, which was not the case earlier. So this happened in 2018 through the rules. Also, another issue which is linked to discrimination on the basis of religion is this visa penalty. So you should know about this, which was in news in the Hindu too. So this is a visa regulation which has been brought out by India in 2018. So under this, the case is that these are also rules, right? So these rules say that penalty for overstay. So if a person overstays in the country, you are given a visa to visit the country. So anybody from outside, in this case, these are Bangladeshi cricketers. So when they come to India, they are given a visa, and if a person overstays, then you have to pay a penalty. So that is penalty for overstay. So in this case, penalty for overstay for a person from Pakistan, Bangladesh and Afghanistan, and these are the same minority communities from Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh, which are mentioned in these rules also in 2018. So these rules say that if they are minority communities, that is Hindus, Christians, Sikhs, Parsis, Jains, so then for them, the penalty would be in rupees. That is, you can see rupees 500 for more than 2 years, 200 for 91 days of overstay, 91 to 2 years, and up to 90 days, it is rupees 100. So if, even if you overstay for 1 day, up to 90 days, you have to pay rupees 100. If you are from minority community from these, but if you are from majority community, that is all these three are Muslim majority countries. So if you are a Muslim, then the case is that a person, if he overstays, he has to pay in dollars. For the same duration of overstay, means even if you overstay for 1 day, it is $300, that is rupees 21,000. So this actually happened, that Bangladeshi cricketers overstayed, and one Bangladeshi cricketer who was a Hindu named Litan Das, he had to pay for 1 day overstay, he had to pay 100 rupees, while another Bangladeshi cricketer, Saif Hasan, he had to pay 21,000 rupees. So this issue was brought by the Bangladesh Foreign Ministry before the Indian government, that this discrimination on religious lines in penalty on overstay, visa overstay, is there. Then another provision which is again on religious lines, or on the same lines as Citizenship Amendment Act, which also happened a year before Citizenship Amendment Bill was initiated, that was in 2018. So this is RBI. In 2018, it kept out Muslim long-term visa holders from property buying rights. So same communities, you can see Hindus, Sikhs, Buddhists, Jains, Parsis and Christians from three Muslim majority countries, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Bangladesh. So same, these are regulations. Again, these were RBI notification regulations under FEMA, that is Foreign Exchange Management Regulations 2018, for acquisition and transfer of immovable property. So for long-term visa holders from minority communities from these three countries, for them, it was allowed to purchase only one residential immovable property in India as dwelling unit for self-occupation and one immovable property for carrying out self-employment. So this was also on the same lines. Only long-term visa holders from these minority communities from Muslim majority countries were allowed, not others. So this was also on the same lines. So basically, you should understand Citizenship Amendment Act is protested against because it is discrimination on the basis of religion. If something has to be provided, it has to be provided to all. If it is about persecuted minorities from these three countries, then persecuted person from any religion. Because even within Muslims, there are many communities which are persecuted in Pakistan, Afghanistan and Bangladesh. So they or any any person who is an atheist too, who does not believe in religion, anybody who is persecuted in any in the countries, then they should be given citizenship by India through this process, facilitation through this process. So that should be the case. It should not be on the basis of religion. So that is the only objection to Citizenship Amendment Act, which is against the constitution of the country. So that is it. Thank you.